how you doing? My name is Michelle Dean. I'm your training manager and Shabam, head program coach at Les Mills Asia Pacific. I have the joy to be able to bring to you the Shabam 15 education session. Now, I'm not doing it alone. I've got the help of my fabulously talented team. So together, we're going to take you through track by track. And we're going to do two things. For each track, we're going to give you the special tip that Rach Newsham gives you, and we're going to reinforce that. And then the second thing we're going to do is we're going to give you one of our own personal tips that's going to help you master that track. And with any luck, you might actually get to go inside one of our trainers' bedrooms. But you'll see that soon enough. So let's get started into it. Track one. Track one is your warm-up. The song's called Get Lucky. And great selection choice, Rach, because Get Lucky was actually named the Song of the Year at the Grammys last year. So a great track to get started. Rachel's tip for this track is two things. The first thing is to make sure that we really clearly coach that back tap combination, so focusing on feet cues. The second thing is Rachel wants us to use this track to really connect to the people in our class. It's a warm-up, it's the perfect time to connect. So no need for some elaborate storytelling, just relax, chill out, and talk to the people in front of you. My tip for you is kind of in line with that. How many times do we get first-time Shabamas coming into our class? Have you noticed what Rachel does whenever she's welcoming those first-time Shabamas? She's waiting till they've done some movement, and then she says, "Who's doing Shabam for the first time?" And by the time that they've already into the movement a little bit, these first-time Shabamas are probably relaxed, and they're thinking, "Yeah, I can do this." And I think that's really clever that she does that. It's one thing I've noticed when I go around and participate in a lot of Shabam classes is instructors will say at the beginning, "Who's doing Shabam for the first time?" before they've even put on the music. And then they go into a bit of a spiel that's all about, look, it takes a while to get, don't worry if you can't get it. If you struggle, it takes a couple of classes, just focus on the footwork. And to me, that sets them up to think that they're maybe not going to be able to do it. Whereas we know that Shabam participants can do it. First time, experienced, it doesn't matter. It's the class for everyone. So make sure that we kind of give Rachel's way a crack, where we're into the class, and then we do the shout out to the new people and reassure them there. Track two, turn the beat around. All right, this is your Latin track. Rachel's tip for this track, it's all about coaching, because we've got that combination where we do the mambo front back, and then it goes corner, corner. So when we introduce that for the first time, Rachel really wants us to make sure that we ask the class members to watch first, so they see the direction changes, and then they join us the second time round. So that's Rachel's tip. The fact that there's so much repetition, they can really start to let their hips go. My tip is because there is so much repetition, I know when I was learning this, sometimes I would struggle because I kind of didn't know if I was up to the third repetition or the fourth repetition. And at the end, the whole combination, there's five repetitions. And because the music's pumping and high energy and there's no really identifiable landmarks in the music, sometimes it's easy to lose track of what repetition you're up to. So my tip to you is, for those five repetitions at the end, script it in a way that you have an objective for each repetition. So for your first repetition, it might just be setting it up and making sure they've got the basics. The second repetition, I'll do a shout out to the back row. Third repetition, I'll do a shout out to the boys. Fourth repetition, I'll do a shout out to the girls. And fifth and final repetition, I'll say, "Show me what you got." And I know by the time I get to "Show me what you got," that's the last repetition, and I'm always going to finish every single time when the music finishes. Cool? So there's my tips. I'm going to hand you over to the very, very attractive Josh, and he's going to take you through track three.
What's up, Shabamas? My name is Josh. I'm from Melbourne. I'm here to talk to you about track three from Shabam 15, which is called Switch. Now, this is a bit of a boys' track. It's a bit gangster. It's a bit awesome. The tip on the DVD from Rach is that when you coach this, you've got to get low on your legs so you can really get the twist in your hips. When she coaches the drop, the squat, the way she coaches it is and one, or and drop, or one, two. So the focus is on the lift before the squat. Now my tip for all the tallies out there in Shabam land, if you're like me and you've got legs like a giraffe, this is going to become your ultimate thigh and butt workout. So what's going to happen is you're going to have to take your feet super wide and drop so you can really turn your legs in, bah, bah, and one, and two, and drop, and one, and two, and squat. And this is already starting to give me a little bit of a workout in my bum already. So that's enough for me. I will see all of you on April 5th at Dancapalooza with the rest of the Shabam team and the Body Jam team, and it's gonna be incredible. So I wanna see you, no, not you, you, and all your dance crew, and all your flashy gear, ripping up the floor at the Exhibition Centre. April 5th, I'll see you then.
My name's Jamie and I'm from Canberra and I'm here today to talk to you about track number 4, She-Wolf. So it is a contemporary track and it's probably the emotional highlight of this release. So let's get a grasp on how to teach contemporary really well. Rach says it beautifully in the Learn the Moves section that contemporary is all about surrendering to the music, to the moves, and to the feeling that contemporary conjures up. If you remember back to AIM, or if you haven't done Shabam AIM yet, you should probably look into it. Remember the feelings that you had when you were dancing to What Now, or whatever the contemporary song was that was chosen in your module. And remember the feelings that you had and that were stirring inside of you and you just got the opportunity to let them out. Well, this is that moment for our members and we get to do that in 3 minutes with She-Wolf. How do we do that? Well, in all honesty, it's a fine line between being super immersive and feeling it for ourselves, as Rach says in the DVD, and also allowing our members to experience that. Remembering that our participants see and copy what we do. So of course we need to be immersive. Of course we need to get the feelings and the suggestions that Rach wants us to feel and to show. Also allowing our members to feel that. So I'd recommend, and my little tip is to just pop a few descriptive sentences about how dance makes you feel or how this song makes you feel, and invite your members into feeling that. Because it's all about how you feel inside and expressing it out. And this is something that you can totally express in this track. In terms of technique, the only thing that I want to remind you, or my little tip to say, would be that when you lift into the combo after the four walks and the step knee, just remember that everything lifts. So it's a lift of the chest. You're lifting onto the ball of the toes. You might want to lift your head so that you can contract and get really internal into the crunch down. I will be seeing you at Phylex on April 5th. And I can't wait to boogie with you on the dance floor. Peace out.
Hi, my name is Johnny, and I am from Brisbane, right here in sunny Queensland. And I'm here to talk to you today about track number 5 from Shabam 15, Work. Now, Rach's hot tip for this track is that it's an amazing leg workout disguised as dance, and that you need to encourage your members to let their hair down so that they can fit right into the tribal feel. The hot tip choreography knows is that this is the perfect time to let the music fill the buzz of the room. That means you can throw yourself right into every sexy move and make sure that your members know exactly what they need to do. My hot tip for this song is that it's so isolated that you need to jump in front of the mirror to make sure that you nail every twerk and every crump so that you sit right in the style of this track. Now, when I say twerk and when I say crump, I mean booty pop and chest pop. Don't be afraid to get low. You need to get low so that your members get low and feel the workout that Rachel wants from this track. Now, don't forget that on April 5th, we have Dancapalooza with Rachel Gandalf, our special guest to Mamatic, and I can't wait to see you there rocking the house with us down in Melbourne. I'll see you then. Bye.
Hi, I'm Hayley Katz Crosley, and I'm from Sydney. Let's look at track 6, Not Myself Tonight. This is the perfect track you've ever wanted to be a backing dancer for Christina Aguilera, and this track is for you. So we have two big blocks of choreography in this track, and my key top tip to learn this track is you really must know your music. Rach wants us to reinforce to be early and clear with our cues. So the way I learned this track, and my little quick top tip, is think of it as two big blocks of choreography and we put them together. Also, think about putting your legs first, adding the arms, then the direction. So that's my little tip for you. The key move for this track to think about is the house run back, and that replaces the march back that we add in the first block of choreography. I'm going to show you sideways. This move has a tipping effect, and Rach reinforces this on the DVD. So come with me. What we're going to do is just go back, 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 back. Be aware not to lift your knees super high. Arms are swaying, butt is popping back. So we'll do it one more time. So you've just got to go back, 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 back. And that's the house run backwards that we do facing the class, of course. So anyway, that's it for me. Enjoy Shabam 15 and see you at Firelex Saturday, April 5th, Dancapalooza. Can't wait to meet all of you. Keep dancing. Thanks.
From Shabam 15. Rach's tip in the choreography notes for this is to really sell the options, which you already know how to do, and to sell the cardio. What we want to make sure when we sell the cardio is to not just tell our participants to jump higher to lift their heart rate or to reach their arms longer. So creative ways. Can you feel your heart beating faster as your love comes closer? Can you jump to cloud nine? Can you reach for your love? Get creative. Have fun with it. A couple of technique pointers. It's jazz ballet. What happens with ballet? We stretch our toes. So any single time that your feet leave the floor, let them stretch. To get the cardio and for your class to get it, not only through what you say, but through what you do. So when you get to that dance phase, you got to get up in the air. You're going to do that by first getting down. Step, jump, step, 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 jump, step, 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 jump, step, 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 jump, step, 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 clap. Cool. The only other move, the step knee. Make sure with this that your knee comes in, your toe comes in, rather than lifting straight up. Because then this is no longer jazz ballet or not the feel of this track. In so that we can hop and reach. And it looks that beautiful and it keeps the same feel of the track. Good? Awesome. I'll see you guys at Firelex.
Yes. How you doing? My name is Luke. I'm all the way from down here in Adelaide. And I'm going to talk to you about Shabam 15 release track number 8, which is called Talk Dirty To Me. You know, like, talk dirty to me. And that's exactly what you're going to be doing to your members and what they're going to be doing back to you and dancing super sexy at the same time. This track is going to be the best track of the entire release, in my opinion. It is hot, it is sexy, and your members are going to want to do it every single week. So, what can you learn from the tips section of the DVD? So, Rachel really breaks down the moves so that you can hit every move super sharp and super hot so that you can really get down and dirty with the moves. Now, in your choreo notes, it's going to tell you to set up the moves with two or three cues so that you can have your members moving really successfully and then just let the music speak. My tip is to jump on the line and Google lyrics. Have a look at where you can use lyrics to be super playful in your class, as well as create some space to just let your members get down and dirty. They just want to grind through this song like you wouldn't believe. Now, also, just have fun with this song, right? Just be super sexy, super playful, and just have your members thinking that they are dancing hot and sexy, just like Jason Derulo's hot music video clip, Backup Dancers, and they are going to love this track. I think this track is so hot, you're going to need a fire extinguisher at the end, trust me. Now, I'm going to see all you guys at Dancapalooza on the 5th of April, Saturday the 5th of April. I'll see you all there, ready to dance. All right, peace out, I'll see you soon. Bye.
Just go where I send you. Where will you send me? I'm going to send you to the land of a thousand dances. Track 9. This track is all about being completely and utterly spontaneous and vulnerable, just like that. You've got to get your class singing along to this one and having a great time. This one's all about digging deep and finding that inner dag, and completely embracing it. And embracing that 60s soul, which, let's be honest, we all kind of have a little bit of, right? Rach doesn't offer too much technique about this track. In fact, in the Learn to Move section, she doesn't mention this track. And that's because the moves are really simple. And the track's all about connection. You just gotta get your class singing along to that na 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 bit, right? I love that bit. By the way, that part of the song was added into the 1965 version by Frankie Garcia because when he came to sing and record the track, he forgot the lyrics at that part of the music. So he just added in na 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 na. Totally cool and totally famous to this day. So that's what it's all about. It's about getting your class to just be completely spontaneous and sing whatever comes to their mind. Don't worry too much about a story in this track. Go with a 1960s theme. Think Dreamgirls or Boys Blues Brothers or maybe even the Sapphires. But just focus on smiles and laughter and singing. That's track 9. Have fun with it. I'll see you guys at Firelex.
Hi everyone, I'm Lou from Perth. So let's have a look at track 10. Put your hands up. This is such a fun track and it is super simple to do. Anyone can do this track, even my mum can do this track. Because it's not complex with the choreography, it's a wonderful opportunity for us to really connect with our participants. Have a conversation with them, chat to them just like they're your friends. Also, it gives us a chance to breathe. My approach to teaching this track was to not overscript. We don't have to go to Brazil, we don't have to break up with our boyfriends again. Have pure, honest fun. So maybe that's something that you can try. If you're relatively new to teaching Shabam, maybe script the first half of the track or have something in your mind and let the second half be. Go with what's happening in the room. Our members absolutely love these tracks when we're launching because they get it. They know what they're doing from the beginning of the track to the end of the track so they can dance hard, sweat and smile. So, although we don't overscript in tracks like this, we still work on it just as much as the other tracks. We don't just focus on twerking. We still put as much prep into these simpler tracks. So, have fun with it, enjoy it, and connect. I will see you on the 5th of April. 5th of April, yeah. See you then.
Hi Shabammers, what's up? My name is Josh, I'm from Melbourne. I'm here to talk to you about track 11 from Shabam 15. It's called Antidote. It was filmed in Sweden, Swedish House Mafia, in a room full of Swedish people, and it's ecstatic. The room is just electrifying. Now, the tip from Rachel on the DVD is that when you're coaching the ski jump, she makes an emphasis on making sure that you don't pivot on your heels, and instead you actually make sure that you jump from side to side. My tip is to make sure that when you're coaching the jump, that you actually tell people to keep their knees soft the whole time, and they actually sink into their legs on the jump, rather than just being upright and static and making it heavy, because then they're gonna injure their knees and that's not gonna be pretty. My other little tip for all the combatters that are out there, you might be a combatter who teaches Shabam, you might have people in your classes who do combat, they're gonna see this and then they go, oh, I can do this, it's a Jenga. Shabam, a little bit of combat, match made in heaven. I will see all of you on April 5th at Dancapalooza. It's gonna be incredible. There's gonna be amazing teams on stage. That's gonna be awesome.
See ya. Ta-da, that's it. 12 tracks of Shabam with the cool down. You'll see it, it's just great fun, chilled out, relax and enjoy. No stress, no pressure. It's what Shabam's all about. So hopefully you've enjoyed hearing from all the team and great news as you've been hearing throughout these last 20 minutes. You're gonna see us all, you're gonna see Rach. Sarah Robinson's also gonna be there. Dancapalooza, this thing. Shabam, Jam, and Timomatic. Very exciting. General public welcome. So please come along, we really hope to see you there. Thanks again and keep Shabamming. See you at Firelex.